Hi friends, this is Kusuma Priya from Vyans Medical Academy. Now I am here in front of you to share my ideas and views about Animal Kingdom. As you all know that Animal Kingdom is divided into two types. Those are non-cottage and cottage. Again, non-cottage are divided into 10 subphylums, which are known as Porifera, Coelenterates, Ctenophora, Platyhelminthes, Ascyhelminthes, Annelids, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinoderms and Hemicottids. The cottages are again divided into three subphylums, which are known as Urochordata, Cephalochordata and Vertebrata. Vertebrata is again divided into subclasses by Agnatha and Gnathostomata. Agnatha is divided into Cyclostomata and Gnathostomata is divided into Pisces and Tetrapods. Again, Tetrapods are divided into four subclasses: apes, mammals, reptiles and amphibians. So friends, I am going to deal with your fewer phylums from phylum Porifera to Molluscans. So first phylum is our Porifera. As you all know that the Poriferans are the sponges and these are the first animals which are present on, which are born on the earth. These exhibit cellular level of an organization and this has a main function which are known as a water transport system or water canal system. And these transport system are taken place in three steps, which are called as an ostia, monocyte and ostium. And the first water enters into the ostia, which are known as a spores. And after entering into the ostia, it goes toward the monocyte. And it, after entering into the monocyte, it enters up through the osculum. My dear friends, examples are mainly important for me point of view. Examples are Cycon, Spongilla, etc. And going on to the next phylum, Coelenterata. As you all know that the Coelenterata are commonly called as Cnidarians. Cnidarians are derived from the neuroblasts and nematocysts. These which are having the stinging capsules. And these exhibit two body forms which are known as polyp and medusa. Polyp is known as sessile and it exhibits cylindrical shape. And medusa exhibits umbrella shape. And examples of this Coelenterata is Physalia, Adamsia, Meandrina and Gorgonia. The next phylum which are called as Ctenophora. Ctenophora is called as comb jellies or sea walnuts. And this exhibits main function which is known as bioluminescence. Bioluminescence means it exhibits light at the night time. And exhibits tissue level of an organism. And these are mostly marine organisms. And examples of these Ctenophora are Pleurobrachia and Ctenophora. And next phylum is Platyhelminthes. This Platyhelminthes organism having the dorsomentally flattened body, which are called as flatworms. And these exhibit triploblastic organisms, and these are acoelomate, and these are bilateral. And this is the first organism which exhibits organ level of an organization. And these are the parasitic forms, hooks and suckers. Hooks and suckers produce nutrients from host, directly from the host, and the specialized cells called as flame cells. And special organism planaria, which helps in regeneration capacity. And examples are Tinea and Fasciola. The next phylum is Ascyhelminthes. And these are called as groundworms, free living, aquatic, terrestrial and organ system level. And these are the first phylum which exhibits the pseudocoelomates. And these excretory waste are removed from the body by the excretory pores. Acharis and Eukarya are the examples of this phylum. And going on to the next phylum, Annelida. Annelids, these are the aquatic, free living and organ system level. And this is the first phylum which exhibits organ system level. And these are bilateral, coelomates, triploblastic. And body surface is distinctly marked into segments or metameres, which are called as annelids. And possesses lateral appendages and nephridia, which is helps in osmoregulation. And examples are Neris and Ferritima. And going on to the next phylum, Arthropoda. This is the largest phylum and this includes insects and two-thirds of organ system, bilateral, triploblastic, coelomates. And this body shows, body is made up of chitinous skeleton. And body is comprises of three parts, which are called as an head, thorax and abdomen. And these has jointed appendages. Excretion is done by the malpighian tubules, and respiratory organs are gills, book gills, book glands and tracheal system. And sensory organs are eyes, antenna, etc. And examples are apis, which are commonly called as an honeybee, bombyx, silkworm, lacifer, lac insect. And next phylum, this is the last phylum, and this is the second largest one. And body is covered by calcareous shell and is segmented with a distinct head, muscular foot and visceral hump. The space between the hump and the mantle is called as a mantle cavity. The mouth contains a file-like rasped apron called as a radula, and pinctera is absent. Soft and spongy layer forms a mantle over visceral hump. Examples are phyla, pinctera, sepia, loligo and octopus, etc. My dear friends, on these two, obviously annelids, arthropods and molluscans, they frame a question at last NEET 2019. They asked that the common characters between three, like bilateral symmetry and triploblastic coelomates, like this, the question like this, and they asked matching, they asked in the form of matching the examples. So my dear friends, please be perfect in the examples and be prepared for the exam, for your NEET exam. Our Vyas Medical Academy wishes you good luck for your NEET 2020.